Hey everyone, Red here. Today I have another fun build for you to try out in your trials. And today we have the Dying Favor Legion build. Today's 30-day series video is going to be a little bit longer than normal as we're going to be including 3 gameplays. And if you enjoy that, please let me know down in the comment section below. That way I can maybe include it for the remainder of the 30 days. Remember, with these 30 days we made a lot of changes, so we do a video every other day. If you guys want, I can definitely overload that with a third or fourth gameplay. That way you really get as much value as it as if you were still getting 30 videos compared to the 15 as we have been doing in the previous months. But with that being said, let's go ahead and get into today's build. We're going to do a quick build breakdown today, so no really in-depth talks. That way we can just get straight into the gameplay. Alright, for our first perk, we have Corrupt Intervention. The 3 generators located farthest from my starting point will be blocked off for 120 seconds. Blood Favor, so long as the hex is up, every time I injure a survivor, the entity will block all pallets within 32 meters for 15 seconds. Thanatophobia, for every injured survivor, they will suffer a penalty to repair, sabotage, and tome cleansing speeds. And last but not least is Dying Light. Whenever you hook a non-obsession survivor, you will gain a token. And for every token, the survivors are going to get a 3% penalty to repair, healing, and sabotage speeds. This does give a 33% action speed bonus to unhooking and healing survivors for the obsession. For add-ons today, I've been really wanting to play around with the decreased Feral Frenzy recharge time, so I took both, the one for 2 seconds and the one for 3.5 for a total of 5.5 seconds off of our power. It does feel okay. I probably wouldn't run it. You probably could run a lot more serious add-ons here and probably feel a little bit better, but I enjoyed it and we really tried building something around it here. Overall, it worked really well for all of our games, so let's go ahead and let's get into the games. So we got Henfield. Weird start. Good Corrupt, though. Corrupt's not bad here. The problem is I just gotta get one, like, right away. Here we go. 2 survivors right away? I mean, this works. Yeah, that works out really well, actually. Oh, I'm coming for you. I wonder if she was holding on to, trying to hold like sprint burst or something there. She shouldn't have this piled up. Nice. Any dead heart, anything like that? No, cool. Blood Favor goes off again. Claudette is being silly with the flashlight. Hey, you can't throw that. Nice. Well, that has the dead heart, though. Works for me. I'll go ahead and take two hooks. I'll probably only get the one, right? It looks like they're running to save. I mean, you can't really get that, I don't think. You can, but yeah, you're going to get hit with it. It was sprint burst. Come back here. Tag this person. That works. We'll just break out of it. Really not that big of a deal. Once we hit her one time, everything in this area is going to become blood papered. Just kidding. It was all a prank. Damn. I was hoping to tag her beforehand, but she didn't drop it, so works for me. Don't mind me, guys. My first game of the day. Holy hell. All right, blood paper went off, and it went off back here. I can hold forward and just kind of cut her off. It's the blue shirt. It's throwing me off, guys. No pallet here. And the only other pallet over here is going to be in a bad position. It's actually not a bad layout for Hanfield. Dead hard? There it is. Cool. All right. Work out some of these pre-games. Carry another bug. How strange. Yeah, I'm asserting dominance, guys. All right. We don't miss here at Red's Gaming Gears. We don't miss. There's no such thing as missing a hit with Red's. All right. It's always intentional. And it's what I like to call asserting dominance. Alright? Remember that. Remember for your game. Someone's like, hey, you missed. You didn't miss, alright? You were just showing the survivors what's up. There she goes. Hey, gamer. Now, she does have a dead heart. So she might use it for a little bit extra distance. Damn it. Oh, okay. I thought I had put myself in the frenzy bug again.
I was about ready to, like, deeply cry. Cool, here she is. Everyone else is over here. Okay. Claudette? Who I'm really looking for. Cool. The other two will have to mend, so they can't be on Jen's. The only one we can be on Jen is the Obsession right now. There's only one strong palette here, and it's this one. Dead hard. Two clicks this time. It's like a dance routine. Give the survivors a couple of warning swings. Exactly. That's how that's how worried you're not. You know what I mean? One survivor almost down. Three stacks of dying light, feeling good. This makes our actual base kick regression a lot better, by the way. You're standing on that gen? Are you kidding me? Very brave. Thank you. We're gonna move back over this way because I want to kick this gen, by the way. All right, kick the gen. Base regression is applied. We'll move over this way. We're trying to get information. We know that no one else is around here right now, thanks to our Feral Frenzy. We would have heard Killer Instinct going off around the corner or something. So now we know, like, kind of the angles are gonna have to play around. Are you making the swap? He is making a swap. Cool. Okay. Yeah, we're not going to play that. We don't really care about the Obsession as much, so go ahead and drop
Smile
it.
Smile with horns.
Nice. Smile with horns? There it is. You know what? I'll just break it. I don't want to waste time with it. And I'd rather just down this forever. We don't care about the Obsession because it doesn't really help us with dying light stacks. We'd much rather get the Claudette out. So, before everyone attacks me for purely tunneling, just remember, there's some idea to it. It's for the build, alright? She can't stay by this, by the way. She can play this one, though. Thank you. Now, the question is, does she have DS? I think the better call is to actually wait it out. At least a split second. Okay. Make her mend. That should be about enough time. They're trying to come for it. I should be fine here. Yeah. How many hits can they take? Only one, right? They could try and take a second one and go down for it, but it's just not worth it. That's fine. Yeah, no one has breakout. We're good here. Nice. Not really a survivor I want. Where's the other survivor? Okay. So they are healing up together somewhere. Oh, they both moved over that way. Yeah. I could have Feral Frenzied it. I might actually frenzy her instead. I think that's the call. Where? Oh, they're quite a ways away. Okay. I'm just going to go ahead and break it. I will down her and hook her now, though. If she's the only one who's injured and the other two aren't on gens, we're kind of fine. And if I can hook her over here where they hadn't have to get forced to head over this way, we're in a good spot. Why are they crowding the hook like that? They're trying to stop Claudette from dying. And they knew she was on death hook. Cool. What we got? I got not really the one I wanted to hook or go for. I see one there. If I can Feral Frenzy her or even see where there may be... working on. She's such a distance away, though. It's really not worth going over this far. Oh, yeah, it is. She's upstairs. We're fine. One's upstairs. We're good here. She just dropped down. I probably could have pulled the game off with her, like the little mind game. Because she's so ready for it. Something means Killer can't place the hook prompt. Thank you for explaining it, Cooper. All right. I mean, both survivors can hop on that gen and work on it, but I don't think there's a lot of value in that. Thank you. Ooh, that was risky. Both these pallets are really bad to play on. How am I going to play it? How are you going to play it? I'll give you the palette. Thank you. So I'll gladly let them take hits. This gives me more Thanatophobia value. One survivor ran off this way, but I believe this was the obsession, right? No, there's two breakoffs. There's one going to the left and one going to the right over here. I'm guessing the one going to the right over here is going to be the one who wraps back around. I would be correct. But it's also at House of Pain. We stayed here for a second. We're not going to play at House of Pain for long, but I do want to do that. The other survivor has to come for the save. And with this, we can see maybe where they're at, if they're anywhere close. It looks like they're just on a gen. There it is. So now we have an idea of where she's at and where she's coming from. Cool. We can go ahead and cut her off from getting to the save. Hey, gamer. That's the whole point of Legion's power, just to get that as much information as you possibly can. Remember when Thana affected healing too? I do. It was awesome. It was a great time. You had a lot of anti-healing builds that worked out a lot better. I wish they'd bring it back actually right now. It'd be kind of cool. I wonder. Do you think maybe? What does she have to play around back here? Let me think. I'll break it. I was trying to think while I was chasing her what kind of things I could have played around. But they're healing up, so I'm fine. Or at least one was healing up, but she'd have a med kit. It would have taken a moment, though. She's holding forward to the other side of the map. It's what you do. But because we have so many people down, we're fine. Oh, she didn't drop the pallet. Kind of brave. Played really well so far. But they have two pallets here. Maybe I should break this chase. I'm an idiot. You know, I've swung her like early every time. Maybe I'm just a goober from Michaelis. There we go. I don't think we have any currently requested. One survivor up there. We'll lose another gen possibly here in a second, but that's okay. There goes Jill, which is the one we're looking for. When I ask someone, do you know how to use a doctor's tape add-on, the one that changes his therapy? Like, which one are you referring to? I can kind of just chase these out from now on. There's really no reason not to. Circle of Healing can be obnoxious. Bring old Thana back would be great. That's what I thought, right? We have so much healing today. Wouldn't it be okay to have old Thana back? They still have a lot of pallets to work with, too. I can't push her this way. She'll get to the other pallet. I think the only way to... Yeah, I have to push her back that way. But I'm pushing her into a pallet either way. I just don't want to push her into the basement over there. That'd be really bad. Yeah, we push her this way. She'll drop it. She might not drop it this time, but she'll drop it. Dead hard? Do we have dead hard? No, you don't. You sprint burst. That's right. I'm an idiot. She just greeted it because she thought I would try and mind game it, but I was trying to figure out which way I wanted to push her real quick. It's very important to always keep that in your mind, too. That's something a lot of killers don't ever talk about or really go over. Like, you're trying to corner a survivor. You're not trying to, like, break a pallet here, let them go across the map. Like, what we did with Michaela, how she's able to get all the way over there. You don't want a survivor to be able to do that if you can help it. Okay. Who's this? Okay, it's the obsession. Cool. The only one, it seems like. Only one pallet over here to play. I wish I could have got her to drop it, now that I think about it. She'll play this pallet. I think she'll play it pretty well, but she'll also probably greet it because she has dead hard. There it is. What? Okay, I wasn't ready for the magic trick. All right, I was not ready for the disappearing act. I just wasn't. No one else could tell me they were ready for the disappearing act, all right? That was not on me. Legit just disappeared. I don't know if I can't get her to a hook. Wow. I can't get her to a hook. I mean, I guess I can just pick her up and let her stun me, right? Hey, do you know where your teammate's at? I'm just gonna take you over to the corner of the map then. Probably waiting for a hatch. Yeah, probably. If she stays over here, I will let her bleed out, by the way. Okay. I can't possibly get her to a hook unless she goes over that way. Oh, she's just gonna do this. All right, I'll let her bleed out. Yeah, that right there, she did again. All right, I'm just gonna let her bleed out. Right, is there, well, hold up, let me see. Is there any way I can get you? Yeah, she's crawling over there intentionally, so. Yeah, all right, enjoy bleeding out, I'm cool. If you're gonna be a survivor who stays in the corner to bleed out, I will let you bleed out. Bondi, thanks so much for the follow. Roman, thank you for the follow. Oh, they did get her up. All right, time to go knock her back down. She'll probably stay over in this area, or they'll be running around. There you are. About fucking time. Holy shit. It's nothing against Survivor. Just boring. Like, the Survivor's just trying to win. But she got over there. They saved. That was a good fake. It was her only option, so I just assumed. Now, does she have... Okay, she's just... I'm a limb. Like, fuck it, dude. Holy hell, this game took forever. I want my 4K now. You know what I mean? Like, if a game lasts forever, I kind of just want the 4K at that point. Did I see message? I think I did. Was it a message with the sub? If Unbreakable goes off, we'll know why she took me all the way over here, but... sometimes... It's less risky to go this way. I could have looked for the other route, but not worth it. Nice. Crazy fast vault, by the way. All right. Oh my God. It's sheltered woods. We should be able to get into a chase pretty quick so long as we catch a survivor moving. We got two over here. Scratch marks to my right, and we saw a survivor to the left. One here. We're definitely... Ooh, we got a lot over here. Oh, my God. It's Legion's favorite dream. Hi, gamers. Oh, man. That is what I like to see. Nope. Can't let you do it. Dead hard. Nope, cool. And Blood Favor stopped her from dropping the pallet. Again, the whole point of the Blood Favor here is to really be able to start, like, it denies the first time, like, the first few times they can really save themselves from a chase. So you get those dying light stacks right away. Oh, man. No one on that gen. We're going to be checking gens. Quickly just patrolling to see what's going on. And then we'll probably head back to Hook here in a second if they're not on a gen. But we have someone right here. Okay. I heard someone else, but that's all right. Did I miss him? Hold up. Oh, here he is. He's like really awkward movement. Cool. Blood Favor will activate. He won't be able to take this pallet up here. He'll go to play. Gotcha. Oh. Just kidding. Turning a lot of dominance today. There we go. All part of my plan. Don't worry, guys. Big brain. What do I want to do here? I can kick this. I think we chase him. He can drop a pallet. Yeah. He's not going to, though. Okay, so he's got dead hard? Yeah. Works for me. Don't really want to hook the obsession. I might just let the obsession chill out for a moment. Again, we're not really trying to kill the obsession. like right away. I'd rather use them as like bait to pull in the other survivors. You know what I mean? Kind of like this. And then we can chase her instead. And if he uses unbreakable, so be it. Like, we're just fine. I don't think she has access to this, does she? She does. Does she dead hard back into it? No. Cool. And now the last survivor has to move from her gen over here, by the way. So I can pull this a few different ways. We'll hook up. We'll hook up. We'll call it good. We'll be fine. I could go and try and really risk it, but then I could lose this survivor, and it is another stack. What is the obsession? The one with, like, the claw marks around them, their character model. So for dying light, we actually get punished for going for that survival. Well, not punished, but if we remove them, we'll remove our own perk. And I don't want to do that early on right now.
Hello, Red.
Hi.
Just came back from work. Is it going good for you?
Yeah, it's going pretty good. We had a long head and shield game, but other than that, we're doing pretty solid right now. Hold on. There we go. I just gotta move my keyboard a little bit. Don't mind me, guys. Clearly, my focus is just not there today. Now, she'll run away from here, though, which is good. The downside is now she's gonna be able to play the palette. And I think she will go for it. But what I might also do is kind of pull off. Let's see what she does. She had light. Okay. Oh, you're both over here. Nice. That's a goober mistake. I hear someone to my right, but it's the obsession. He's sitting there trying to do a totem. Face him off. Don't really have much interest in him. He's, you know, again, we have zero interest in the obsession with this build. Are you sure? Hey, dude. He makes it. He'll vault it this time, by the way. Because last time I got him on the mind game, and he didn't try and think two or three steps, he should have done the same move again, thinking I would try and call his bluff. But that's where the mind games get into the TNLs. Watch your cheerleads for the killers. Pretty good. Thank you. Yeah, we'll tag him real quick. That's what we're looking for. Hey, can you please stop? Thank you. These guys are in so much trouble. Lots of stacks. We had a lot of quick hits. Really good spawn for us overall, too. Same props for teaching me backpack build on Pyramid Head. Ran it all day, and not only did you profit, but it helped me have fun, which means still free. Exactly. It's actually funny too. If you actually like play at a little bit calmer level or like for fun, sometimes you actually perform a lot better. It's one of those like really crazy, like, again, if you're always playing to win, you can sometimes tilt yourself in the beginning of the game, and then that can throw the whole game for you right there. You know, your own mental can literally kill the game. Nice dead hard, broski. Don't worry, I've been a goober this game too. It also helps you let go if you happen to get like a god squad, you know what I mean? Like just a really, really top-notch squad of survivors. You get like the top 10% in one of your games because you're high MMR. And if you're trying to play like super serious, it can feel like you're getting that all the time when you're really not. There we go. MMR is saying you have no way of knowing how high it is. I mean, if you win enough games, you should have an idea that you're probably high MMR. That's about the extent of it, right? Like, if you're winning 80% of your games and you've been doing it every day since MMR came out, your MMR isn't, like, staying super low. It's not like League where you're going up by, like, 8 LB, you know what I mean? And then we had the introduction of, we just found out recently that the MMR also doesn't perform well for newer players. Because we just saw that in the patch notes, which is fine. It's not going to, but like when you think about it, so like newer players, oh my god, they've been trying to bless so much. Oh, you're just cleansing. Wow. Yeah. And there's even, like, really good survivors can also just have bad games, too. This. Refreshing lobbies also helps with MMR. I guess. I mean, it wasn't so much refreshing the lobby. It was when people leave and someone comes in, it's just trying to fill a spot. So sometimes you get like the one like newer player because they're filled into the spot, which just adds, again, there's just a big difference between the solo queue environment of survivors and the Swift environment. If you go against Swift, your game's probably going to be much harder. But we already knew that, so it's not any different than it was a few months ago, you know what I mean? I'm not so clear how to play Puddle Freddy right in a loop. Do you place puddles somewhere in the same area as trappers? No. You're typically placing them on, like, the middle section of a loop, right? So the survivor has to hit it and then run through it. Or you're placing it, like, if it's a long... Hold up. I heard someone breathing. Thanks, man. So, like, say you have... Give me a second. I'll explain it in 1 second. All right, there we go. Again, really good corrupt layout. Now, the totem, not so much, but I might just play on this side a bit. He's got some distance on me. Ooh, he's got less, though. 2 survivors over here. I might get some value. Oh, my gosh. Chill, dude. Thank you. Hey, yeah, there's not really any pallets here. You good? Nice dead hard. Gaming. Blood favor. Love it. Like, non-menacing and killer looks. If they have a weapon, they kind of have the upper hand. Yeah, we thought we were going to lose it early this round. That's fine. We have Steve. Dwight is trying to mend. So we can go for Steve here. I kind of want to be on this side anyways, if possible. No one else is here. I want to keep him around this corner. Again, we're trying to corner the survivor, and we're going to run him this way. I can't outplay this loop in any way, but what I can do is just chase him down and then see if he has dead heart or something like that. Nope, cool. Now, if for some reason he dead-hearted that, he would have been able to drop the pallet or run it one more time, but we're still in a good position because he has nowhere to go after he drops the pallet. What are your thoughts about Coconut RTS? I don't really like to talk about streamers, but, I mean, I like Coconut. I think he's a really nice person. All right, first off, click, click. Can I do this while... Yes, I can. Cool. Because that allows me to get back over here a little bit. Or see who's coming over this way. No one. So Dwight is the only one who can come over here for your save at the moment. And he's over here mending. I can maybe try and play this side completely. Nice. I didn't think you'd be able to dead hard inside. At least I got rid of that, though. They got a lot of pallets over here. This is going to be pretty rough overall. Come here. Oh, you pain. We're going for her. But we're going this way. Again, we want to try and chase her as much over there as I can. She does have dead hard, so she'll play it out. Nice. She still has dead hard. Yeah. I'll keep her on us. Really solid flashlight flick there. She went for, like, an FOV tag. I'm surprised she held her dead heart for so long. That's very brave. All right, 3rd stack of Dying Light. Let's go. Nice dead heart by Dwight. Yeah, I'm surprised he didn't get caught. I feel like if that was me, I would have gotten caught on, like, the door there and just been, like, denied. They put the boon back, but that's okay. Again, we can play around the boon if they keep setting it up over here. Oh, yeah. Nice. All right. We'll chase him up here. There's no way I give this for free. Nice. Even better. There it is. Make her use that hard. Nice. Hell yeah. One other survivor here who's kind of looking at me. I see him though. I'm gonna pick up. We're fine. It's also the obsession, so I'm also okay with that. I might kind of chill out for a second. These guys are pretty competent, but they're also very, very greedy survivors. So I most likely have DSs on my hand because they want those second chances. I also want to keep this corner if possible. Two survivors over here, one on the ground. She has unbreakable. It's not like I'm getting anything anyways, right? Gives me a teabag, so he's trying to get me away from the hook. But I can just kind of do this. I can watch. They have to come through here, right? It's either that or I get to play my way. We're not going to play a survivor's rule and just run over there for no reason. Eyeballing it. We're fine. No DS. Cool. I get to remove a player from the game. He's just faking it. Yeah. And then there she goes. She's DCing. She's very unhappy. And she has to let me know. Thank you. And we swap over to him. Now remember, these are survivors who were clicking and stuff a second ago. But you just gotta not... Don't play by their rules and go for... the win. He greeted that again, man. Crazy. There it is. He got lucky. That's very unlucky for us, but lucky for him. Because he got stuck. He didn't go where he wanted to with that. Goddamn, I'll be surprised. How about now? Yep. Big Brian Blaze can't kill him if they DC. True. One survivor over here kind of eyeballing me. Again, it's always possible they have DS, too. Hey, gamer. I'm also looking for Dwight right here. Nice. That men will take a second. That heart is so weird. Yeah, it can be. I expected Dwight to maybe set up the boon again. Okay. Know when to not commit to a chase when they... Yeah, exactly. Dwight will come over here and try and get my attention. Yeah, see? You hear him clicking? But I don't want attention anyways. Because, one, he's the obsession, right? So, I don't want him because of dying light. You can tell he's very angry, so I'm getting my way here. I'm like, I'm totally okay with this. Him being greedy like this is just securing the win for me. There we go. Is there a Legion buff tomorrow? Not that I've seen. You know that if they DC, they don't give you MMR points for killer, right? I don't care. Like, at all. Like, not about, like, the whole MMR system in general. I think that, like, yeah. But that'll be changing here soon, too, it looks like. He'll just run. Yeah. He's very greedy, very confident. He'll probably die hard here soon. Nope. He tried to 360 it with the flashlight. See, after a few games, man, you ain't tagging me with the 360s and stuff anymore. Like, I'm awake. Click, click, click. Yeah, exactly. They're so greedy. Yeah, but they're very confident. Like, you can tell that they're very confident survivors. But you can play around confidence. Like, like we did with the Dead Hard a few times. Like, you can just hold forward then. If you're going against good survivors most of the time, especially if they're running dead hard, you're just going to hold through the pallet. Did you see that means you have an easier next match? No, not like that. It just like, think of it as like a null and void. There you go. He kills himself to give her hatch possibility. How does deep wounds work? As long as they're running, it won't lower, but if it ever reaches zero, so if it ever, if the bar ever lowers to zero, you'll dip down. Aren't you just gonna take that? Oh, girl, you fucking fight back.